In our last discussion, we talked about the prospective application of laws and the exception to the general rule, retroactivity. As I've mentioned in our previous discussions, the study of the law is the study of the exceptions. Our last discussion is full of exceptions to the exceptions. And as is often the case in law school, narito ang bulto ng mga itinatanong sa mga quiz at recitation. In case you missed our previous lectures, there is a link in the description down below para makahabol ka muna, kapatid. Moving on, Article 5 of the Civil Code provides that acts executed against the provisions of mandatory or prohibitory laws shall be void except when the law itself authorizes their validity. Whenever the law mentions mandatory, the law is laying down for us that which is required. When the law says prohibitory, the law is telling you what is not allowed. The way to remember it is mandatory means kailangan. At kapag prohibitory naman, nangangahulugan na bawal. There aren't any cases decided by the Supreme Court on the strength of this provision, and that's because it is plain and simple. This makes it an excellent opportunity to teach about verba legis, or the plain meaning rule. One of the most difficult subjects in law school is statutory construction. Makikita mo ang subject na to sa first semester ng first year. Dito, pinakamataas ang attrition. I remember our freshman class from many, many years ago na dosena na lang kami na nag-finals dahil terorista ang prof namin. Kapag apak mo ng third year or fourth year, kapatid, maiisip mo na hindi naman pala mahirap ang statcon. Naging mahirap lang siya dahil sa prof. Statutory construction takes work, a lot of work. Kahit 2 or 3 units lang siya, may mga madaling araw at gabi na iisipin mo na major subject siya, na feels like 6 units siya. This is because statutory construction is the only course in law school that will give you all of the tools you need to learn the law. Dito mo matututunan kung paano intindihin ang batas dahil dito maraming kaso at maraming babasahin. Going back to our discussion, the most important rule in statutory construction is the verba legis or plain meaning rule. The rule comes from the Latin maxim verba legis, non est residendum. In English, this means from the words of a statute, there should be no departure. Ang sarap pakinggan, kapatid, at masarap ding ulit-ulitin. The plain meaning rule means that when the law is clear and there is no doubt or ambiguity, there is no room for construction or interpretation. There is only room for application. Again, Article 5 of the Civil Code provides that acts executed against the provisions of mandatory or prohibitory laws shall be void, except when the law itself authorizes their validity. We know the meaning of the words mandatory and prohibitory. Napag-usapan na natin yan. Wala ring part ang provision na ito na malabo. So applying the plain meaning rule, if there is no doubt or ambiguity in the language of the law, then we have to apply it in its literal sense. Sabi sa Article 5, kung sinabi ng batas na sumunod, susunod tayo. Kapag sinabi ng batas na bawal yan, bawal yan. Any act we do in contravention to the law is void. Article 2 of the Family Code provides that no marriage shall be valid unless these essential requisites are present. Number 1, legal capacity of the contracting parties, who must be male and female. And number 2, consent freely given in the presence of the solemnizing officer. This is a good example of a mandatory provision of the law that lays down for us the requisites for a valid marriage. Notice, kapatid, that the law says these essential requisites. Hindi niya sinabing one or some of these essential requisites. If for whatever reason a person decides to marry a box of pizza, that marriage is void because a box of pizza does not have legal capacity at hindi rin siya male or female. Again, acts executed against the provisions of mandatory laws shall be void. Elsewhere in the Civil Code, Article 1027 provides that the following are incapable of succeeding. Number 1, the priest who heard the confession of the testator during his last illness, or the minister of the gospel who extended spiritual aid to him during the same period. This is a prohibitory provision of the law. kung ipagpipilitan ng isang lola na pamanahan ng pari na nakinig sa kanyang huling kumpisal, that will be void. The reason is Article 5 of the Civil Code. In this scenario, the priest or the minister exerts a very unique influence over the mind of the testator. Maaaring gamitin niyang influence na yan sa mabuti o masama. That is why in the wisdom of the law, ipinagbawal na lang niya na pamanahan natin sila. The rule in Article 5 provides for several exceptions. Pero intro muna tayo. All of this and more coming right up! Hi, my name is Lex and welcome to Lex in Motion. In this channel, I'll be helping you build your competence, confidence, and capability in law school. Start today by hitting the subscribe button below. New episodes are posted every Friday. Article 5 of the Civil Code admits of several exceptions. These are 1. When the law itself authorizes their validity. 2. When the law makes the act valid but punishes the violator. 3. When the law makes the act voidable. 4. When the law declares the act void but recognizes legal effects arising from the void act. The first exception is easy, kapatid. The exception itself is found under Article 5, when the law itself authorizes its validity. Kung may parcel ka, kapatid, na galing overseas, there is a contract between you and the carrier that your package will arrive safely to your doorstep. Kung sakaling may bagyo o sakuna na dumating sa barko na magdi-deliver ng parcel mo, the law authorizes them to jettison or throw cargo from the vessel and into the sea if doing so will prevent the ship from capsizing. Malinaw ang contract of carriage between you and the carrier. Kung itatapon niya ang package mo, pananagutan niya yon. Pero kung gagawin niya yon para hindi lumubog ang barko, one of the instances when the law authorizes or somehow validates the act, then the act itself is valid. Mali kailanman ang bumaril ka ng kapwa mo tao, pero kung ito ay gagawin mo alang-alang sa self-defense, then the law authorizes the validity of shooting another person. Provided, lilinawin ko, provided the requisites under the revised penal code are met. Mahabang discussion ito, kapatid, at dahil wala naman daw ako sa mga law school na nabanggit, we will discuss this concept when we get to criminal law. Second exception, the act itself is not valid but the law makes it valid but punishes the violator. The best way to understand this is from the Supreme Court decision in the case of SMDC versus Ang. In this case, a managerial employee of the SM Development Corporation was dismissed. The reason for his dismissal was valid. There was a just cause. However, the act of dismissing him was void because it did not follow due process. In this case, Gilbert Ang was not given the opportunity to confront the witnesses against him. In this case, the Supreme Court ruled that if the dismissal is based on a just cause, then the non-compliance with procedural due process should not render the termination from employment illegal or ineffectual. Instead, the employer must indemnify the employee in the form of nominal damages. Sa kasong ito, kapatid, mali ang dismissal dahil hindi sumunod sa process. Again, a mandatory provision of the law. But because of the exception, the dismissal is valid. The punishment or penalty of the violator, in this case SMDC, is the payment of 30,000 pesos as nominal damages. Exception number 3, when the law makes the act voidable. In order for us to understand this exception, we must first lay down the status of contracts. Contracts can be valid, voidable, or void. A valid contract meets all of the requirements of the law. A voidable contract is one that is valid until it is annulled. A void contract is one that does not meet the requirements of the law. Strictly speaking, a void contract does not exist. It is illegal and cannot be enforced. An action to challenge a void contract does not prescribe. It has no expiration period. Now, the way to remember it, and this was how my professor taught it to us many years ago. Class, sabi niya, ang valid, pumasok, lahat masaya. Ang voidable, pasok sana at pasok pa naman hanggang hindi hinuhugot. At ang void, yan ang walang-walang chance. A voidable contract is one that occupies the space between a valid contract and a void contract. It is valid for the time being, but it can be challenged. And that is an action of declaration of nullity or annulment. Because it is valid for the time being, pwedeng-pwede mo rin siyang ipavalidate para matigil na kung anumang duda ang meron sa validity. This is called ratification. For most voidable contracts, the law itself specifies how they can be ratified. Halimbawa, a person who is between 18 years old and 21 years old needs a document called parental consent to be married. Between the ages of 21 years old and 24 years old, that document is called parental advice. Ngayon, kung 19 years old ka, kapatid, at dahil hinding-hindi na mapipigilan ang iyong damdamin at damdamin ng iyong kasintahan, nagpakasal ka ngayon. Kahit paayaw ng nanay mo dahil daw hindi graduate ng UP or Arneo ang jowa mo. What is the status of your marriage? If we go by Article 2 of the Family Code, the marriage is valid because you are over 18 years old and you are male and female respectively. However, because the law requires that you submit an affidavit of parental consent, which you did not produce, then the status of your marriage is voidable. It is valid according to Article 2 of the Family Code, but may nevertheless be annulled or challenged, or validated, or ratified. Ratification is found under Article 45 of the Family Code. Paragraph 1 teaches us that upon attaining the age of 22, one of the parties, ikaw in our example, freely cohabits with the other. Nagsama pa rin kayo. And the two of you live together as husband and wife. Then, with your cohabitation, your marriage is now ratified. The fourth exception is when the law itself declares the act void but nevertheless recognizes legal effects arising from the void act. The best example is found under Article 36 of the Family Code, which provides that a marriage contracted by any party who at the time of the celebration was psychologically incapacitated to comply with the essential marital obligations of marriage shall likewise be void, even if such incapacity becomes manifest only after its solemnization. Psychological incapacity is a technical term in family relations. It's a very simple concept, but it becomes very complex the more you read the cases. Kung sa 10 tanong sa final sa persons and family relations, mahina na 30% ang masasagot gamit ang Article 36 ng Family Code. At its essence, psychological incapacity refers to a party's inability to understand the obligations of marriage. The wisdom of the law is that kung ang isang tao ay hindi nauunawaan kung ano o paano maging asawa, then it means that there was no marriage right from the start. Hindi naman kasi niya alam o naiintindihan kung ano ang pinasok niya. The inability referred to in Article 36 of the Family Code refers to the inability to comprehend and understand the covenants of a marriage. It does not mean inability to perform or inability to comply. Kung ikaw kapatid ay nasa hustong gulang na at alam mo naman ang pinasok mo, hinding-hindi ka pwedeng kasuhan ng annulment dahil sa psychological incapacity, dahil ayaw mong mag-comply, o puro rank game lang ang inaatupag mo. The inability in Article 36 does not refer to physical inability, hindi yung dahil batugan ka lang talaga, kundi dahil sa psychological inability. Mahaba pa ang discussion sa psychological incapacity, kapatid. And we will get to this once we cover family relations. For now, what you need to remember is that a marriage can be annulled under Article 36 of the Family Code. When the court annuls such marriage, it declares that the marriage is void and strictly speaking, walang kasal na naganap. However, following our fourth exception, this marriage is void, but the law recognizes several effects. One of these legal effects is laid down for us in Article 54 of the Family Code, which provides that children conceived or born before the judgment of annulment or absolute nullity of the marriage under Article 36 has become final and executory shall be considered legitimate. Children conceived or born of the subsequent marriage under Article 53 shall likewise be legitimate. The legal effect is that kahit maanal ang kasalan under Article 36, ang mga naging anak during this marriage are considered legitimate. This is a very important status that comes into play elsewhere in the Family Code and the Civil Code provisions on succession. To summarize our rules, Article 5 of the Civil Code provides that acts executed against the provisions of mandatory or prohibitory laws shall be void except when the law itself authorizes their validity. The exceptions are 1. When the law itself authorizes their validity. 2. When the law makes the act valid but punishes the violator. 3. When the law makes the act voidable. 4. When the law declares the act void but recognizes legal effects arising from the void act. I think we can stop here, kapatid. If you would like to see more of this kind of content, let me know in the comments below. Kahit simpleng yes lang. Finally, there is a short quiz para naman masubukan natin kung may natutunan ka sa mga ilang minutong nagdaan. Thank you so much for watching. Like and share this video for Good Law School Karma, and I will see you next Friday.